So at a service station just outside Northampton, it's about 11 o'clock at night. MK Dons 1, Walsall 1. Fair point for each side?
Yeah, to be honest, MK were like the better team in the first half. Walsall were the better team in the second half. But to be fair, both teams were absolutely shocking. Yeah. Both teams were absolutely poor. I've only seen one worse team than MK Dons this season, and that was Oldham. We're yet to play Gillingham, so let's see what Gillingham bring. But to be fair, 1-1.
Just keep it rolling.
You can see his face.
So Gillespie made a few blunders. He looked a lot better in the second half. Quite a lot of blunders in the first half. Can you see any improvement in him? I can't.
No, you've got to give him a chance, though. Look at what Cutler did with Etheridge and O'Donnell. You've got to give Gillespie a chance to form into a good keeper. He's making far too many mistakes, but you can't fault him for their goal, I don't think. I thought the defence was flat-footed again. He made so many changes. He went to 4-4-2. I don't understand why he dropped Devlin. I think it was because it was his birthday and he just gave him the day off. Osthuizen got dropped, and Osthuizen was probably one of our better players on Saturday. And then you look at Bakayoko. Baka can't get dropped. No matter what Baka does, he will not get dropped. And I understand what people said at the weekend. He's our player. We've got to nurture him. We've got to give him a chance. But when you've got Adji and you've got Roberts, they are the best two strikers that we've got at this club. So you will play them in a 4-4-2. So I can't understand why you play Baka tonight.
So you've just briefly covered the starting 11, but a lot of fans are saying it was a bad selection from Whitney. And we just listened to his interview and he said that it was for rotation purposes. I mean, it was a shocking selection for what is a fairly tough away game.
To be honest, Whitney comes out with so much crap every week, I don't know what to believe anymore. He took the players up to Camp Cassius in the summer, made them the most fittest team in the Football League, and we're now literally, 16, 17 games into the season, and he's already throwing the tiredness factor, the injuries, and you can't take what he says. You've got to take what he says with a pinch of salt. And tonight, the fans were more vocal than I've ever seen. Yeah. We got vocal at the home game. But tonight, we had literally probably 50, 60 fans in the back of the Milton Keynes tier. And they were all chanting Whitney out. At the end of the game, Whitney came over, sarcastically clapped at the fans. And that just wound fans up even more. And the board have got to book it now. They've got the book stops now. We cannot continue. The fans are getting on the manager's back. The manager sarcastically clapping the fans. And we can't let this continue because it's just going to run through the club. And before we know it, we're going to be sucked into that relegation. There's going to be no fight, no hunger from the fans or the players or the staff. And we're going to end up being dragged into it. And we're going to have a real fight on our hands.
So just covering your last few points, there's no going back now for Whitney. I think he's wound up the fans, and surely, even if he went and got some results, the fans don't like him anymore.
No, to be honest, Whitney was liked as a bloke, and everything that runs through Whitney's veins, the pride, the passion, the hard-working ethic that he keeps going on about, everyone was warming to that. But tonight and Saturday, when he sarcastically clapped the fans, everyone is fed up. We are fed up of it now. We can't keep supporting someone that is just in it for himself. And he is literally just in it for himself. There is no Walsall Football Club. There is no fan base behind him. It's just a mess. It really is just a mess.
Quickly to end it, because I'm absolutely freezing. Doncaster on Saturday, a couple of days away. Results?
To be honest, we will probably grind out a result. We probably will go there. We may win. We may draw. But I honestly just think we are playing the waiting game now. we could probably give 2 or 3 games now, drawing, winning, I don't know, but in the long run, come February, March, we're going to be sucked into that relegation scrap with Whitney in charge. And I don't want to say it because Whitney is a good bloke, but I can't see anything past that, and the board need to act now.